Good morning, this is Sister Sheila, and I'm delighted to welcome you to the Worship Experience today. Thank you so much for joining us. So now join me as we go to our worship experience.
I can say I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better.
Welcome to our Youth Service Sunday. God has blessed us to be back in school, and we should give him all the praise for keeping us safe. Now for the invocation. May we bow our heads. Dear God, we invite you to this service. We ask you to receive our praise and worship. May what we do please you this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, church. I'll be lining the hymn, I Need Thee Every Hour. I need thee every hour, most gracious Lord, no tender voice like thine.
Church, and today I'll be reading in Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 through 7, and it states, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thy own eyes. And I have read for you Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 through 7.
Now it's time for our prayer. Father, I thank you for this day that you have blessed us with, God. I thank you for continuing to bless us and keep us from harm and danger, God. I thank you for being with us, God, as we continue to be in this back-to-school season, God. Help us to understand and comprehend what is being taught in our classes, God. And help us to have the courage to ask questions, God, even when we don't understand, God. Allow us to have favor with other students, God, and teachers, God, and other staff, God. And also, God, I ask you to continue to protect us from any sicknesses that are surrounding us, God. I ask you, God, to heal those that have been impacted by any sickness, God. And also, God, I ask you, God, to open up the hearts of your people, God, so that they can understand, God, and be touched by this word and this service that you have given us today, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
I need your glory. I want your glory, Lord. Less me and more of you is what I need. Show me your glory. Show me your power. Less me and more of you is what I need. I need your glory. Yeah, yeah.
I want your glory.
God, I want your glory, Jesus.
Less of me.
Less of me and more of you, Lord, is what I need. Show me your glory, Jesus.
Show me your power,
Lord. Less of me and more of you.
Less of me and more is what I need.
I need your glory so many times that I strayed away, rejecting your love and your warm embrace. I realize I need you more and more each day. Show me, Lord, show me your glory. Lord, I want your glory. Less of me and more of you, Lord. That's what I need. Show me your glory, Jesus. Lord, I need your glory, God. I need your power, Jesus. Less of me and more of you, Lord. Hey. So many times I strayed away, rejecting your love and your warm embrace. I realize I need you more and more.
Worship this morning. We thank and praise God for how the Holy Spirit is in our midst. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to say thank you. And God, right now, we're asking you to tune us in even the more to receive your word, God. We need a word from you, God. We need a word from you. So minister to us, oh God. Speak to us, oh Lord. Speak through these lips of clay. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Get your Bibles this morning and turn to Proverbs chapter 3. Proverbs chapter 3. The wisest man in all the Old Testament wrote the book of Proverbs, and he wrote it under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And on that note, my subject is, advise us, Holy Spirit. Advise us, Holy Spirit. We're in the season once again where students are back at school or going back to school. And while they face this time of going to school, they will have or experience tight schedules. They will have new teachers, new friends, and a lot of peer pressure. And they also will be faced with what is right and what is wrong. School is the mouse race that equips us for the rat race. Let me say that again. School is the mouse race that equips us for the rat race. Praise God. Yes, school is that little world for students that is supposed to get us ready for that real big world out there we call life. Now, what kind of advice would the Bible give you as you go back to school? There are all kinds of persons trying to give students advice today. Praise God. You got the teachers. You got their peers. The peers are in their ears. The teachers are in their ears. Everybody's trying to give advice. And we are always looking for the place to get the right kind of advice. Praise God. We look for advice or suggestions on how to cook, how to get fit, how to be healthy and stay healthy, how to do this and how to do that. People are just looking for advice. Well, I want to tell you the greatest advice that you can find in this world is the Word of God. Just think about getting advice from the wisest man in the Old Testament, and his name was Solomon. Solomon was a wealthy man. He was a man who knew how to invest. He knew how to govern. He knew how to run a business. He knew it all. And he's a man who gives a tremendous word of advice in the book of Proverbs. Today, we're going to talk about the value of trust. Who can you trust for advice? Praise God. Well, Proverbs, let me tell you, Proverbs, the third chapter, we're there. That fifth verse says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not unto your own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct thy path. We should trust in the Lord, not just haphazardly, but we should trust in the Lord with all our heart. Hallelujah. We're living in that time, glory to God, when all the news reporters have emphasized again and again that people in America don't trust anybody anymore. We don't trust our neighbors. You know how back in the day, we used to have relationships with the neighbor. Neighbors was just like family. We could trust our neighbors to take care of our children while we were at work when they got out of school. We don't trust our neighbors anymore. We don't trust our friends. We don't even trust our spouses. Hallelujah. You find those when they see their spouse's cell phone laying there, they're tempted to pick it up to see if there's any numbers on there that shouldn't be. Hallelujah. The moment we put our trust in someone or business and give them our money, we find out later we've been scammed or we've been taken advantage of. We even trust doctors with our lives. Hallelujah. And we don't even know them personally. We don't know these people personally, but we put our trust in these strangers. We put our trust in them, and we put our lives on the line with these doctors. But we won't even trust God concerning his word. That if he said it, or whatever he said, I'm going to believe it. I'm going to trust God at his word. Now, Solomon, oh my God, Solomon, the wisest man in all the Old Testament, became king after his father, King David. Solomon didn't know anything about being a king. All he knew was that he loved God and he wanted to follow through with what his father, King David, desired to do. And that was to build a house or a temple for God to dwell in. And this pleased God. God was so pleased. He was well pleased with Solomon's love for him. Oh God, it pleased God to the point that God asked Solomon, "What shall I give thee? Tell me, Solomon, what should I give you?" And Solomon said, "Oh God, I'm just a little child. I don't know how to go out or come in." Pastor used to say this in his prayers. "I don't know how to go out or come in." Hallelujah. Solomon said that. He said, "You placed me, you've made me king, and you placed me over so great a people. So could you just give me an understanding heart to judge the people that I may discern between good and bad? Could you just do that?" And guess what? God was so shocked. He was so pleased with Solomon's request that he not only gave Solomon his request, but he also blessed him with riches. Hallelujah. That he didn't even ask for. He blessed him with riches and honor. Hallelujah. Solomon's wise counsel is found right here in the book of Proverbs. And chapter 3 tells us how to seek wisdom. And focusing on verses 5 and 6 of Proverbs 3, it says how we should trust God. And trusting God will cause us to be full of wisdom, full of God's wisdom. Verse 5 says, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart." All your heart. You trust in God with all your heart and all your soul and all your mind and all your spirit. You just focus on God and his word. And you don't lean. It said, "And lean not unto your own understanding." You don't even trust yourself. You don't trust your thoughts. You don't trust what you may think is right. You don't trust it. You lean on God's, hallelujah, on God's word, on what he says, praise God, hallelujah. And then it says, "In all your ways, just acknowledge God." Just acknowledge God. Give God the credit, hallelujah. If you do something and it's successfully done, hallelujah, give God the glory. To God be the glory. God did it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank God. God is the one that's responsible for my victory. Praise God. Acknowledge him. And when we acknowledge him, it says he shall direct thy path. He shall lead and guide and direct us. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That's why we can say, "God, hallelujah, advise us, Holy Spirit. Advise us, Holy Spirit." And when we ask God to advise us, hallelujah, when we ask the third person in the Trinity, Holy Spirit, guide us, use us, do what needs to be done, praise God, He will then direct our path. He will lead and guide us. Hallelujah. So ask Him. So ask the Holy Spirit to advise you. Ask Him to give you advice. Tell the Holy Spirit you need Him. Hallelujah. Just like it stated in the morning hymn today. It says, I need thee every hour. Praise God. Most gracious Lord, no tender voice like thine can peace afford. I need thee. Oh, glory to God. Look up to heaven and say, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee, praise God. Hallelujah. And then there's another verse that says, I need thee every hour in joy and pain. Come quickly and abide, or life is just vain for me. Oh, come, Holy Spirit. Come, Heavenly Dove. Lead and guide me. Give me the advice that I need on this journey, hallelujah, that I'm on, hallelujah. Our students, lead and guide you and direct you in what's going on in your school, hallelujah. How to handle this and how to handle this and how to handle whatever that comes before you. Oh, God, we need thee. Oh, we need thee. Every hour we need thee. Oh, bless us now, my Savior. We come to thee. Oh, God, we tend to put our confidence in man, but we don't want to put our confidence in God. Oh, we got to notice that it is God that will give us the victory. It is God that will see us through in troubled times, in perilous times, in times that we don't know what to do. We don't know how to handle it. This coronavirus that we're going through right now, we're all thumbs. Our hands are tied behind our backs. No one knows, hallelujah, how long this is going to last. We thought we was about out of it, and here's the Delta variant. We just don't know. The only one that knows and the only one we can go to that can give us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, hallelujah, that can give us the advice that we need, hallelujah, to survive, hallelujah, to get out, to be successful, hallelujah, to overcome, hallelujah, is the Holy Ghost, hallelujah. So Holy Spirit, advise us, Holy Spirit, hallelujah. Notice, hallelujah, when Solomon asked for wisdom, God granted it, hallelujah. Note, when you ask God, hallelujah, for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, He'll give it to you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Note, hallelujah, when you lean not to your own understanding, the word says, hallelujah, God will direct your path. Hallelujah. Note, when you trust in God with all thine heart, hallelujah, with all your soul and with all your spirit, hallelujah, God will see you through. Hallelujah. Yes, notice, I stated that Solomon was the wisest man of all in the Old Testament. And let me emphasize, it was the Old Testament, because Jesus was the wisest man in the New Testament. Jesus came on the scene, hallelujah, in the New Testament. And He was the wisest man, hallelujah. Glory to God. He came, hallelujah. He came to be our example. He came to show us what we needed to do, praise God, hallelujah. It was a perfect example, glory to God. Hallelujah. Couldn't get no more perfect than Jesus Himself, hallelujah. And then it was time for Jesus to leave the scene, hallelujah. And when He left the scene, He made way for the Holy Spirit. He made way for the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And the Holy Spirit inspires and empowers us today. Hallelujah. With wisdom, with knowledge, with understanding, with the advice that we need. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I challenge you today, glory to God. Don't go anywhere, hallelujah, without the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. When you wake up in the morning, say, okay, God, hallelujah, here I am. Hallelujah. About to experience another day, glory to God. And I ask that you empower me with your Holy Ghost. Empower me with your wisdom. Empower me with your knowledge. Empower me with your understanding. Empower me with the advice, hallelujah, that I need, hallelujah, to be successful on this day. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When Satan comes, hallelujah, to test me, glory to God, to tempt me, hallelujah. Holy Spirit, hallelujah, I ask you to give me the words to say, to speak back to the enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus, glory to God. When my peers, hallelujah, at school, hallelujah, hallelujah, don't want to accept me for who I am, glory to God, but they want to make fun of me. They want to tell others negative things about me, glory to God. Holy Spirit, advise me how to handle that situation. Glory to God. Holy Spirit, give me the confidence that I need to stand tall and walk, hallelujah, in their presence, hallelujah, because I know, hallelujah, without a shadow of doubt, that I'm not alone, that your Spirit, glory to God, your Spirit of grace, your Spirit of love, your Holy Spirit is advising me, praise God, your Holy Spirit is leading and guiding and directing me. It's your Holy Spirit, praise God, that I need, hallelujah, to survive. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Not only the students, we adults today, we go through many things. Glory to God. We confront situations, praise God. But I'm challenging you today, whatever you're going through, hallelujah, whatever you're going through, glory to God. And get the advice of the Holy Spirit. Ask the Holy Spirit to advise you. Hallelujah. Ask the Holy Spirit to lead and guide you. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Hallelujah. To allow you to gain the victory for whatever you're going through. Praise God. Hallelujah. God, hallelujah. The third person in the Trinity, the Holy Spirit, is here, hallelujah. He's here to lead and guide you. You're not alone. You're never alone because he walks beside you. He talks and he guides your footsteps every day. Glory to God. I challenge you, hallelujah, to take the hand of the Holy Spirit and let him, hallelujah, dwell on the inside of you, dwell richly on the inside of you. Hallelujah. Let him use you. Let him lead and guide and direct you. Let him speak through you. Glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Let him give you the confidence you need to stand up. Hallelujah. And say, for God I live and for God I die. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Advise us, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Advise us. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Now, I'm praying that there's someone out there that just heard the word, and the word did something for you. I mean, just shook you up today, knowing that there is someone that is with you at all times and in all places. You don't have to worry. You don't have to fret. You don't have to fear. You just begin to speak to him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Form that relationship with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And let him lead, guide, and direct you. Glory to God. In the mighty name of Jesus. If there's someone that has not giving your life over to God, you haven't asked God to save you, you haven't asked God to get on the inside of you and lead and guide and direct you, I ask you right now to repeat this prayer after me. Glory to God. It's a prayer of salvation in the mighty name of Jesus. Dear God, we thank you for your precious Holy Spirit. First of all, God, I realize in order to receive the Holy Spirit, I need to be saved. Father, I'm a sinner. I need you to save me. I realize that I need a Savior. So come into my heart. Come into my heart right now, God. I confess my sins. I confess them right now, God. Clean me up from these sins. And God, come on in the inside of me. I receive you right now. And I thank you for saving me. And I thank you for blessing me and filling me with the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name I do pray. Amen. Thank God. Thank you, God. Oh, praise God. Praise God. We thank God. Hallelujah. I'm praying that you are rejoicing like me. Praise God. Hallelujah. When you have accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, hallelujah, he is rejoicing. The angels in heaven is rejoicing. Everybody is rejoicing because you're a part of the family right now. So you need to thank and praise God and be happy. Hallelujah. Whatever that was keeping you down, whatever that had you depressed and sad and head hung down low, glory to God. You don't have to do that anymore. Begin to praise God. Hallelujah. And thank him for your salvation. Thank him. Hallelujah, for receiving the Holy Ghost. And now that you receive the Holy Ghost, glory to God, you can ask the Holy Ghost to advise you. You can ask the Holy Ghost to fill you with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You can ask the Holy Ghost anything, hallelujah, that you so desire. Hallelujah, because you're saved now. You're connected with him now. Hallelujah. And that's what it's all about. Also, praise God, hallelujah. If there's someone out there that needs a church home, St. James is here. We welcome you to be a part of our family. Oh, glory to God. We would love to hear from you. Why don't you call the number on the screen or write it, type in the chat, and let us know that you are willing and looking for a church home and desire to be a part of St. James. God bless you. Praise God. And we want to love on you, and we want you to be a part of this family. And finally, those of you that have special requests, need someone to pray with you about something specifically, call that number on the screen, right on the chat, and someone will be there to pray for you. Glory to God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
The ways to give are as follows. You may give through PayPal, Giblify, or you may choose the pay through the mail-in option. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for all the many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. God, now it's time for us to give back to you what you have given to us. Father God, open up your children's hearts and allow them to see that when we give back to you, Lord God, that you will bless them beyond their own heart's desires. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Announcements are as followed. Today at 3 o'clock, the Missionary Society of the Jacksonville District is having a hat extravaganza. Zoom information is on the screen. Also, on Wednesday at 6:30 is St. James Planning Meeting. The following day, Thursday at 6:30, is our District Mass Meeting.
Then on Sunday morning at 9:15 a.m., we're having intercessory prayer. Then at 9:30 a.m. is our Sunday school. Then at 10:45 is our Sunday morning worship. Have a blessed day.
And now for the benediction. And now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us, henceforth, now and forevermore, let us all say amen. God bless you, and remember, ask the Holy Spirit to advise you. Amen.
Glory, goodness, and mercy.